What are the major fund investment trends for 2017? Well, standing back and taking a look at the data for the year so far, one of ICI's top economists, Sean Collins, shares his insights.
This year is shaping up to be a great year. We're seeing combined inflows into mutual funds and ETFs this year, so far through the end of August, of about almost $400 billion, and that compares with about $80 billion for the previous year. So, looks to be a pretty good year.
Those are big numbers. Can we break down the categories a bit, and in particular pick up on what's going on with bond funds, because people are always looking there to see when something is going to happen.
Sure. So, one thing that's really interesting about the bond market is that long-term interest rates in the U.S. have varied a lot since last November, reflecting changing views about tax reform and monetary policy. We're down a little bit in terms of long-term interest rates so far this year. Overall, though, investors seem to have taken it in stride and have continued to add considerable amounts to bond mutual funds and bond ETFs throughout the year, so about $275 billion through August alone.
All in between those two categories.
Exactly.
And then what surprises do you see? Anything in the data that you found interesting?
Yeah, so there is one surprise. One thing that we've seen is the U.S. stock market is up about 10% so far this year. Despite that, we've seen modest outflows from funds that invest in U.S. stock markets, about $30 billion. So that's a little bit of a surprise. Part of the explanation may be that world stock markets are up even more, about 15% through the end of August. And we've seen strong inflows into funds that concentrate in world stocks or international stocks.